Ladies, I'm honored to be here celebrating Bahrain's Women's Day with you. This day is strategically timed to coincide with the Bahrain's National Day celebrations in December, as both of these occasions should be cherished by all Bahrainis. This memorable day was first launched in 2008 under the patronage of Her Royal Highness, Princess Sabika bint Ibrahim al-Khalifa, the wife of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa al-Khalifa and President of the Supreme Council for Women. The theme of this year's Bahraini Women's Day is Women in Diplomatic Work, which coincide with the Kingdom's celebrations of the 51st anniversary of its former diplomacy and Diplomatic Day. Bapco and Bahrain share a long and rich history. Together, in many ways, we share a history of first. First oil in the region, the first Gulf state to have education and social organizations for women, the first Gulf state to send women to study abroad in 1937 with three distinguished ladies to complete their education in Beirut, Lebanon. The first to have women in high-ranking positions in government, such as ministers and ambassadors. It's hard to remember that women were only permitted to vote in Bahrain less than 20 years ago. From our current enlightened perspective, we can look back at these achievements and say, of course, but we cannot forget the struggles of women who paved the way, those whose shoulders we now stand, we look down the road into the future, the efforts to achieve full empowerment, and equally that we struggle for today will look equally normal, equally, of course. Of all of the achievements that Bapco has made throughout the years, I'm proud of two of them. First of all, the unflagging dedication to uphold the highest standards of excellence in safety. And secondly, the continuing efforts to ensure that we have the best people in our workforce. Bapco has trained generations of employees who have gone on to improve their own lives and lives of their families, and ultimately the lives of every citizen of the kingdom. Along the way, we have ensured our support for the development of women in the company. More than 50 years ago, the company helped to empower the women of that era to become more financially independent. Today, building on the back of the kingdom's commitment to the education of women, we offer full scholarships to young men and women choosing to study chemical or mechanical engineering and other related disciplines in some of the finest universities in the world. With the growth of the Oil and Gas Academy, our range of courses, and the development of career plans will further multiply the opportunities for all of our employees. 1 year ago, I stood in front of the women of the company and asked them to guess how many women we had in senior management. The answer, zero. Today, I'm pleased to announce that the Bapco's Board of Directors has approved two women to join the management team, our new Chief Financial Officer, and Bapco's new Chief Legal Counsel. We also have Manager Planning and Economics, Manager Corporate Strategy, Acting Manager Operational Excellence, and Leader HR Transformation. In the near future, you will see more women in management positions, not because we favor women over men, nor because we want to promote women just because they are women, but because we believe in appointing the right person to the position. I deeply believe that talent and ability are gender neutral, and I will always seek out the best talent without regard to where it is found. I see your faces at the work and in our company's publications, and I see many untold stories. The truth is that most women struggle more than men because of the weight of responsibilities. There is a married woman who struggles with teaching her children after working hours, especially during the pandemic. And yet shows up at work every day and does her best. There are unmarried women who struggle with their sick parents, and they take care of them while maintaining outstanding performance at work. There is a young woman who is trying to finish her degree and yet continues to pay to prove herself at work. We see all of you. We recognize your efforts. We appreciate you, and we are here to celebrate you today. Today, more and more women are working alongside men in Bapco, and in the BMP, and some women are in the lead. We can say with pride that Bapco women march first on December 1st. Let me close by expressing my heartfelt and deepest congratulations and gratitude to all of you exceptional women here today, without exception. Thank you and stay safe.